Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. I am physics teacher Hina Amjad from APS 4th roll. I welcome all my 10th class students in online support program. This is week 5 and the topics from your textbook are from page number 26 to 32. So let's start our topics. The very objective this week is that students will be able to learn that how sound is reflected and produces echo. That means that how does reflection takes place, and the second is the variation in the speed of sound with medium. That how does speed of sound varies with solid, liquid and gases. The third one is the harmful effects of noise pollution, and you are very well aware of these noise pollutions. And the fourth one is importance of acoustics in our daily life, and the fifth one is uses of ultrasound in medical and technical field. So the first topic is the reflection of sound, which is also called as echo, and its definition is when sound is incident on the surface of a medium, it bounces back into the first medium. This phenomenon is called echo or reflection of sound. As you are very well aware of the reflection, so the concept of the reflection of sound is the same. Here I should clear, the first medium, it means the air, for example, and incident on the surface of a medium means it can be a solid or it can be a liquid. So there should be two medium, in order to understand or in order to have the reflection of sound. As the sensation of sound persist in our brain is for about 0.1 second. So we can find the total distance that covered by the echo of the sound by using the formula S is equals to Vt, where V is the speed of sound in air. As you know, it is 330 to 340 meter per second, and the time is 0.1 second. So it comes out as 34 meter. So the total distance taken by the reflection of sound is 34 meter. That means the obstacle should be at 17 meter, the half of it, in order to have a clear echo. There can occur multiple echoes, like whenever you speak. So it doesn't mean that there is only one wave of sound which goes to the obstacle and comes out. There can be multiple amount of waves of sound which goes towards the obstacle or which goes in the other directions, and it creates different echoes. So there is an activity in your textbook, which is activity 11.3. As you can see in the figure, that we have placed two pipes on the table at a particular angle, such that the angle of incidence and angle of reflection should be equal, and there is a screen in between these two pipes. At one side of a pipe there is a clock, and the others on the other pipe we have placed so that we can hear it. And we can hear the tick-tock of the clock. So we will place the pipe at such a point where we can hear clearly the reflection of the sound or the tick tock of the clock. So our next slide is about the speed of sound, which is the next topic. You are very well aware that sound requires a medium to propagate because it is a longitudinal wave. So it requires particles medium to vibrate, and the speed of sound is dependent on the media, especially the solid, liquids and gases. And its speed is more in solids as compared to the liquids and gases. It is estimated that the speed of sound in liquid is 5 times greater than that of gases, and the speed of sound in solid is 15 times greater than that of gases. And it is very clear from the figure that why it is greater in solids, because the particles of the medium of solid are very close enough to vibrate and transfer that energy, to transfer that sound energy. and the particles of the liquid are a bit far, and the particles of the gases are more far as compared to the particles of the solid and liquid. And the speed of sound is also dependent on the physical conditions, that is temperature, pressure and humidity. Like the more will be the temperature, the more vigorously the particle will vibrate and they will transfer energy more quickly as compared to if the temperature is low. You know, the relation of sound is V is equals to F lambda, where F is the frequency and lambda is the wavelength of the sound. So our next topic is measuring speed of sound by echo method. And we are going to perform that experiment and we will measure the speed of sound. For this, we need apparatus, that is measuring tape, stopwatch, flat wall that can produce a good echo. And the procedure is very simple. We have felt it in our daily life that if we clap and we have placed the wall at the distance of 50 meter, so the total distance covered by the echo would be 100 meters, because the distance covered from clap to the wall and from wall to the back, okay, that is going to be 50 plus 50 is 100 meter. So the obstacle is at the half of the distance, that is 50 meter. So first we will clap and we will hear the echo if it is clear or not. Then after then as soon as we start the first clap, we will start our stopwatch, and after 10 claps we will stop the stopwatch, and we will note the time for the 10 claps by taking the average of the 10 claps. By performing this experiment 2 or 3 times, we will take the average of the time, and then we will calculate the speed of sound by using the relation S is equals to VT, where S is the distance, V is the speed, and T is the time. The time that we calculate from the stopwatch, and S is the distance, which is 50 meter, and V we will calculate by rearranging the relation V is equals to S by T. So this is very easy and we can do it. So our next topic is noise pollution. And you have learned and you have heard about it a lot, that how noise is very bad for our health and for our hearing effect. So the definition of noise, that the sound which is jarring or unpleasant effect in our ears, is called noise. And the definition of music is that the sound which has pleasant effect on our ears is called music. So the noise that we hear in our daily life is the sound of the traffic, the sound of machinery and the slamming of the door, etc., which we do not feel good, which doesn't feel good to our ears. These are the noises, and it is very harmful for our health, as it causes different issues like hearing loss, sleep disturbance, aggressions, hypertension, high stress levels, and it can cause accidents by interfering with the communication and warning signals. An estimated level of noise that we can bear is 85 to 90 decibels, and more than that causes these damages to our health. And we can avoid noise pollution by replacing the noisy machinery with environmental friendly machinery and equipment, by putting sound reducing barriers or using hair protection devices, as it is your daily life experience, or you can say observation, that when we take out this silencer from the motorbike, it causes a lot of noise. And when you put the silencer back in the motorbike, it reduces its noise. So that silencer is the environment friendly machinery that reduces the sound of motorbike. Okay. Our next topic is the importance of acoustics in our daily life. And what is meant by the acoustics is the technique or method used to absorb undesirable sounds but soft and porous surfaces is called acoustic protection. As we have studied in the previous topics, that there can be multiple reflections of sound. So this multiple reflection causes the gobbled of the sound. So this multiple reflection can be stopped by using such soft and porous materials. So by using such materials in noisy places, we can reduce multiple reflection and the level of noise pollution. And why we want to control it? Because the sound reflects from the wall, ceilings, and the floor of the room. The fixtures are too reflective, and the sound becomes too noisy and garbled. So this multiple reflection of sound is called reverberation. So in order to avoid the reverberations, some soft and porous materials are used in order to avoid reverberations. And generally, the ceilings of the lecture halls, conference halls, and theater halls are closed so that the sound after reflection may reach all the corners of the hall. Sometimes curved sound boards are placed behind the stage so that sound after reflection distributed evenly across the hall. So the multiple reflection is beneficial, as it distributed the sounds very well across the hall. And sometimes this multiple reflection is not good, as it causes the noise pollution and it disturbs the sound. So this is very important, that especially in theater halls, lecture halls, that how you have constructed the halls, just to see whether the sound will reach at every corner of the hall or not. So the cinemas especially, they are designed in such a way that the sound reach at every corner of the hall. So our next topic is ultrasound. The basic definition of the ultrasound is the sounds of frequency higher than 20,000 hertz, which are inaudible to normal human ear, are called ultrasound or ultrasonic. As you know, the hearing sound for human ear is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. That means less than 20 hertz and greater than 20,000 hertz, we can't hear it. So the sound which is more than 20,000 hertz frequency, this is frequency, is inaudible for human ear, and this is called ultrasound or ultrasonic. As you know, the relation for the waves is V is equals to F lambda. F is the frequency and lambda is the wavelength. By looking at the relation, we can see that the higher the frequency, the higher will be the speed, and less is the wavelength. Why? Because frequency and wavelength have inverse relation. So its wavelength is very small. That's why it is used for detecting very small objects. And because of its property, we use it in medical fields in order to diagnose the different disease, like tumors or cancerous cells. How we do it? That as you can see in the figure, that the person is holding a transducer, and it is keeping it on the body, and it is watching that thing on the screen, that is giving the reflection of that inner part of the body. And there are multiple reflection colors, and the detective part that we want to detect, it gives the different color of that defected part. So they reflect it into the human body, and after reflection they give the different colors on the screen, from which by seeing at the image we can detect the defect in that organ. And the second one uses that they are used to remove blood clots form in the arteries. And the third benefit is that we can get the picture of thyroid glands for diagnosis purposes, and it is used to kill germs and bacteria in liquids by using high intensity ultrasonic waves, and other its uses that they are used to break the stones in the kidney as well. It's and they are very helpful for it. Okay, the next sound is in the technical field, and which is to locate underwater depth, or is used for locating objects lying deep on the ocean floor. Is for this we use ultrasound, and this technique is called sonar. And as you can see in the figure, that the ship is throwing these sounds into the water, and they are going into the water, and they are reflecting back from the ocean bed and coming back on towards the ship. So by calculating the total time they have taken to come back, we can calculate by using the relation S is equals to Vt, the distance, and we can find out that how deep the ocean is, because we know its velocity, we know its we calculate the time, and we can find out the distance. The second use of it in technical field is that we can find out the cracks that appear in the metal parts. Sometimes such cracks are not visible, they come within the metal and we can't see it clearly. So these ultrasound waves are used to see the cracks that appear in the interior of the moving parts of the high speed heavy machines such as turbines, engines of the ships and airplanes. So due to its excessive use, and how we find out that a powerful beam of ultrasound is made to pass through these defective parts. While passing, these waves are reflected by the surface of these cracks and flaws, and the comparison of the ultrasonic wave reflected from the cracks and from the surface of this part, which are fine, gives the clue of the existence of the crack. So this is also very convenient and useful technique of it. So this is all from this week, and thank you so much.